Okay, good morning class. I am Professor Megha Nair. I am your class teacher, so you all know me. So today we are going to talk about Unit 2, Integrated Marketing Communication Subject, Advertising. Now what do you understand by the term advertising, or how does the word advertising come into picture? Advertising has emerged from the Latin word that is advert, which means drawing attention towards something. So the main purpose of an advertisement is to draw the attention of the customer or the consumer towards itself so as to increase the sales, plus assist in brand management, imaging, product development, sales and all other aspects. Top of the mind. What do you understand by top of the mind? You all know marketing has four marketing mix. What is that? Product, price, place and promotion. Similarly, you also have STPD analysis, that is segmentation, targeting, differentiation and positioning. So when an advertisement is released, advertisement is based on your marketing mix. What is the product, where is it selling, what is the promotion, that is advertisement, where is the, what is the price, etc., introductory offers, non-introductory offers, everything comes under your advertisement. So positioning, you all understand what is positioning. There is product positioning and there is brand positioning. So product positioning means making the customer aware, or you can say making the customer so familiar with that particular product that whenever you think about it, the first name that comes to your mind is regarding that brand. So for example, every time we go to buy chocolates, we always say a Cadbury dena. Cadbury per se is a brand, it is not a chocolate, but we have associated or positioned itself in that way in our minds. Now who has done this positioning? It has been done through advertisements. Similarly, if I go to buy noodles, what is the first thing that comes to my mind? Maggi noodles. But we have Sunfeast, we have Patanjali, we have so many other brands, but still the first thing that comes to my mind is Maggi noodles. Now why is that? It is because those brands, because of the advertisements, are always on top of my mind. Now, advertisements are generally paid form of non-personal communication about either the organization or the product that they are selling, the service or the idea by an identified sponsor. Now who is an identified sponsor? Now if Maggi noodles is the advertisement, the identified sponsor will be the company, that is Nestle. Similarly, if I am selling Bonvita, the identified sponsor will be the company, that is Cadbury, and Cadbury is now Mondelez Foods. So therefore, any advertisement, you put it anywhere, any media, always is a paid form. The only non-paid form of advertisement existing is called as the word of mouth advertisements. And word of mouth advertisements are generally unintentional. Unintentional in the sense, if I am buying something, I like the product, I will recommend it to somebody else without expecting the company to pay me money. That is only because I use the product, I would like my friend or my relative or somebody else to use the product. So word of mouth is the only advertisement that is which is not paid. Many organizations also pay you for word of mouth advertisements. That is, you have to go to 10 different places and tell them that please use this or please use this product, it is very nice, etc., etc. They are paid. Okay, so you have advertisement, paid form. So the key points: paid form, non-personal and identified sponsors. Non-personal because there is no face-to-face communication between you and the company or the salesperson when it comes to an advertisement. Features of advertisement. First thing, there is no face-to-face contact with the customers. If I am putting an advertisement on TV, am I actually talking to the customer or am I actually talking to the company if I see the ad? No. face-to-face happens when, if there is a salesperson involved. That comes under the personal selling process. There is no face-to-face contact with the customers that when you have an advertisement. Similarly, advertisements can be of three forms. Oral advertisements, okay, word-to-mouth communication, and similarly, when I am recommending something to somebody else, comes under oral communication. You have written communication, which are print ads. Then you have visual communication, which are your TV, or you have on your internet, when you have ad displays on YouTube, they come under visual. Also, radio is a form of oral communication, because you per se do not see the RJ over there, neither do you see the customers, neither do you see the brand, you don't even see the packaging of the product, no nothing. Therefore, it is an oral advertisement. Then, why do I need an advertisement per se? Objective is to raise demand for a product. Until and unless I don't tell the customer or I don't identify the market and tell them that yes, I exist in the market, I am a company which sells so and so products, please come and buy, nobody is going to know about me. So if nobody knows about my product, nobody buys my product. Therefore, advertisement helps create an awareness about my product or my brand in terms of, good way or in a bad way to 10 different people so that people come and buy my product. Generally, negative advertising is done more on a social cause, so that when you see a negative advertisement, you feel a little emotional about it or you feel a little bad about it and you work. Especially for NGOs or maybe, when all these bombing attacks happen or when a tsunami comes. So on social causes, you have a negative advertisement. Ads should disclose the source and the sponsor of the advertisement. Source, which is the product, who is the company, and who is making the advertisement. So the organization which does the advertisement or which is manufacturing the brand itself comes as the source and the sponsor. So this way you have certain features for a particular advertisement. Role of advertising. As we saw in the previous slide, to create a steady demand. So you all know about the product life cycle. There is initiation phase, there is a growth phase, then there is a stagnation, and then there is a decline. So whenever a product is in its stagnation phase, okay, that means that product has a steady demand. For example, you have Colgate, you have Pepsodent, toothpaste and all. These products are always in use. Aisa koi din nahi hai or there is no other day when you do not get up and you don't brush your teeth or do something. So therefore, when you have toothpaste, when you have salt, when you have milk, you have dairy products like butter or bread, these are always in demand. Now, Amul Butter keeps advertising its product in the form of either a hoarding or an advertisement or something else. Now, but is it actually necessary for them to do it? They are the number one in the market currently, Amul Butter. But still, so that people don't forget about it, they keep doing the advertisements. And they have a steady demand, or you can say there is a steady stagnation in their product life cycle. Meeting competition. If I take the example for say Pepsi. Pepsi is sold throughout. Har nukkad kone mein, dukaan mein you get a Pepsi, anywhere you go. Competitors, Coca-Cola, similarly Coke bhi available hai. If I have a retail shop jo Pepsi bechta hai, wo same shop will also sell me a Coca-Cola. But how can I increase my sales? All depends on the advertisement I make. So Pepsi, nowadays if you go to see, there are not many ads that come out for Pepsi. But Coca-Cola still is trying to get the customers towards itself by creating ads on open happiness. Uske aajkal jitne bhi ads aate hai, sab ekdam jingli, ekdam gaane waane dalke, bachcho ko leke, sab karke, open happiness karke, they have created an ad. They are still trying to remain in the customer's mind so that they meet their competition, that is say Pepsi. Similarly, if you all ever go to say Domino's or Pizza Hut or any of these eateries, jabhi bhi aap Pepsi mangoge, toh un log Coke ka bottle laake dete, generally. Now, why this happens? It is because they have already had ties, or you can say certain type of a merger with them, so that every time a customer comes into my eatery to eat something, they will get a Coke bottle whenever they ask for it. So automatically Coke ka sales increase hota hai as compared to Pepsi or other branded products. Increase in goodwill. The best way to increase in goodwill is how? If I do some CSR activity associated with it. So for example, you have that PNG, Procter & Gamble. आप कोई भी प्रोडक्ट प्रॉक्टर एंड गैम्बल का खरीदते हो तो एक रुपया शिक्षा के लिए जाता है फॉर द गर्ल चाइल्ड. सो इन दैट वे आई एम सेलिंग माई प्रोडक्ट्स ऑल्सो, मेरा सेल्स वॉल्यूम भी बढ़ रहा है, आई एम डूइंग CSR ऑल्सो, प्लस इट इंक्रीजेस द गुडविल फॉर माई ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल, निहार शांति आमला, विद्या बालन आती है, सेम कॉन्सेप्ट. आप निहार शांति आमला लो, उसका एक सर्टन अमाउंट बच्चों की शिक्षा के लिए हम डोनेट करेंगे. सो उससे सेम थिंग, इट अगेन क्रिएट्स अ डिमांड, पीपल विल बाय दैट, CSR एंड गुडविल. सो वंस देयर इज गुडविल इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, ऑटोमेटिकली द कंपनीज रेप्यूटेशन एंड इमेज ऑल्सो इंक्रीजेस अ सर्टन अमाउंट और टेन फोल्ड. और अगर ऑटोमेटिकली गुडविल अच्छा है, कंपनी का इमेज अच्छा है, देन पीपल विल नो दैट ये प्रोडक्ट या फिर ये ऑर्गेनाइजेशन जो है सेल्स गुड क्वालिटी प्रोडक्ट्स, एंड आई डोंट हैव टू थिंक ट्वाइस और थ्राइस टू बाय द प्रोडक्ट. सो इफ आई कीप गोइंग बैक टू दैट सेम ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बिकॉज ऑफ गुड गुडविल, दैट मीन्स आई ऑल्सो जेनरेट कस्टमर लॉयल्टी. सो यू सी हाउ थिंग्स आर इंटर रिलेटेड. Educate customers is equivalent to creating awareness in the customer's mind about my product. That is what an advertisement does. आप ये toothpaste लो, इसमें cooling crystal है, फिर आप दांत ये करोगे, सफेद होगा, etc. etc. All this comes under educating a customer on how they use that product. Promotes standard of living. In rural areas, पुराने जमाने में especially, अगर टूथब्रश के बदले मिसवाक का लकड़ी आता था. सो इन सिटीज मिसवाक का लकड़ी मिलना इज अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट टास्क. सो उसके बदले व्हाट डिड दे डू, डाबर केम आउट विद मिसवाक टूथपेस्ट. नाउ व्हेन आई एम गोइंग फ्रॉम वन लेवल टू अनदर, ऑटोमेटिकली इट रेजेस माय स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ लिविंग. देन इफ आई कंपेयर अ सिटी लाइफ टू अ रूरल लाइफ, रूरल में मुझे KFC, मैकडोनल्ड्स एक्सेट्रा या फिर ईटरीज, पेस्ट्रीज, ये वो सब कंपेरेटिवली नहीं मिलेगा या तो कम मिलेगा, बट आई गेट मोर इन सिटीज. देयरफॉर इफ आई टारगेट और इफ आई फोकस मोर ऑन सिटी पीपल, इट ऑटोमेटिकली इंक्रीजेस माय सेल्स बिकॉज देयर स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ लिविंग इज हायर. अगर मैं मुंबई में जॉब कर रही हूँ और किधर गाँव में जॉब कर रही हूँ, ऑटोमेटिकली सैलरीज हाई. So if my salary is high, marketing wants, needs and desires are also high. मैं यहाँ पर पिज्जा जाके खाया, मेरे फ्रेंड ने जाके खाया, चल मैं भी ट्राई करके थी, आई विल ऑल्सो गो टू दैट प्लेस टू हैव अ पिज्जा बिकॉज ही सेड इट इज गुड. सो आई एम पुटिंग माई मनी एंड दे आर ऑल्सो अर्निंग इट. इंट्रोड्यूसिंग अ न्यू प्रोडक्ट. सो विच इज द लेटेस्ट प्रोडक्ट दैट हैज कम आउट इन द मार्केट. Anushka Sharma is selling something called as True Derm, which is a new shampoo for dandruff. So before she used to be associated with Pantene, abhi Pantene chhod ke, now she has launched a new product called as True Derm, which is for dandruff. So kya hua hai? She is the brand ambassador, she is also selling the product and she is also introduced it in the market. New product introduction. Supports the salesman. यूरेका फोर्ब्स जब शुरू हुआ था, दे यूज टू हैव डोर टू डोर सेल्समैन. एवरी टाइम कोई ना कोई आता था, हमारे पास नया वाटर प्यूरिफायर है, नया फिल्टर है, it will, you know, clean the water, etc. Karke they used to sell. After a certain point of time, when the company went on from the survival mode to getting market share, they started what? Creating advertisements. Now, since advertisements ek hi saath bahut sare logon ko pahunch jata hai, people started noticing that yes, Eureka Forbes karke company hai which sells water purifiers. And now, if the salesman comes to me to sell it, then I know that yes, this is a genuine person and this is a genuine company. Why? Because I have seen the advertisement on TV or I've heard it on radio. So advertisement also helps you create trust with the salesperson. Similarly, insurance products. Insurance products mein kya hota hai? Insurance products mein you have all these Kotak Mahindra Bank, you have LIC, ye sare log insurance ka advertisement karte hain. But bechte kaun hai? LIC agents hote hain. So I either call the agent to my house or I go and visit the agent in his office and get my LIC done. Now LIC agent is also a form of a salesman only for that particular insurance. So this comes under role of advertising, where advertising helps a lot of creating demand, creating awareness and higher sales volume generation. Advantages. There are advantages to three people when it comes to an advertisement. For the business, that is the organization selling the product, for the consumers who are using the product, and finally for the entire community or society. Meeting competition. Mera advertisement agar kisi aur ke advertisement se better hai, to obviously people mera product khareedenge. Or for example, now Coca-Cola and Pepsi. Pepsi is not making any ads, but Coca-Cola is still making ads. So people will now think about Coca-Cola more as compared to buying Pepsi. So helps me meet competition. Again, it helps me create a steady demand for my particular product. Higher sales volume. Automatically, if there is a demand, then there has to be a supply. Jitna zyada mera demand rahega, utna mera supply increase hoga and utna mera sales volume bhi badhega. Introducing a new product, I gave you an example recently just now. Expansion of market. If I am an entrepreneur, or say if the organization has just come into existence and it has focused on Mumbai's market, that is people living in Mumbai. Humne yahan pe use kiya, achha laga. Agar Mumbai mein big gaya, okay, now let's try the second city, say Delhi. Why? Standard of living in Mumbai is somewhat the same that exists in Delhi or in Bangalore or in Chennai. Why? Because these are cosmopolitan cities. So agar ek city mein chal gaya, automatically there is a chance that wo baki cities mein bhi use ho sakta hai. So I can expand from one market to another when it comes to an advertisement. And if you always notice, advertisement changes languages, at least in India, the moment it leaves one particular territory. Maharashtra mein, the language will be Marathi. Kerala mein, the language will be Malayalam. If I go to Kolkata, the language will automatically change to Bengali. But the advertisement remains the same. It's all lip sync or, you know, dubbing and all. But still, to attract the customer and to make the customers feel ki ye hamara product hai, they change the language. So again, it helps you enhance goodwill. And last, employee morale. If the organization's product is good, the quality is good, so automatically the employees also feel very motivated to be associated with such an organization. So for example, if I take the service industry, everybody feels proud when they work in Infosys or TCS or, you know, Wipro or such organizations. Why? Because the quality of work, the quality of work culture, environment and the products that they sell are all top class. Therefore, the employees automatically feel motivated and have good morale. Advantages to the consumers: convenience. मुझे मिसवाक का लकड़ी का जरूरत नहीं है, आई हैव अ टूथब्रश, आई हैव द मिसवाक टूथपेस्ट, मेरा काम हो रहा है, आई कैन गेट रियली फ्रेश ब्रेथ एंड एवरीथिंग, क्लीन टीथ, इट इज कन्वीनियंट फॉर मी ऑल्सो टू कैरी अराउंड इन 10 डिफरेंट प्लेसेस, दैट कम्स अंडर कन्वीनियंस, नॉट ओनली दैट बट ऑल अदर प्रोडक्ट्स एज वेल. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आई डोंट नो टू कुक, बट मैगी नूडल्स है, डाला, पानी में डाला, मसाला डाला, हिलाया, इट्स डन. So even if a person doesn't know to cook, a proper meal can survive by eating Maggi. So it is a convenient product for me. Education of consumers. If I have to create awareness, I automatically educate my customers about the product that I am selling. Better quality. If I have goodwill in the organization and if I have a good image reputation, automatically the quality of my products also increases tenfold. So McDonald's, anywhere you go in the world, has a standard operating procedure that burger banana hai to aise hi banana hai. The patty should be so soft, the thickness of the patty should be this much, the buns are supposed to be fresh and hot. So all this is what they offer, quality food or quality product to consumers worldwide. Consumer surplus, if the consumers are happy, your demand increases, automatically the people or the consumers will also keep buying your product, which in turn will generate customer loyalty. So this comes as advantages of advertising for the consumers. What about the society? अगर मैं प्रोडक्ट बना रही हूँ, ओके, आई हैव अ कंपनी एंड मेरा प्रोडक्ट का पोर्टफोलियो है शैम्पूस. नाउ शैम्पू में आई हैव शैम्पू फॉर नॉर्मल हेयर, आई हैव शैम्पू फॉर डैंड्रफ हेयर, आई हैव फॉर हेयर फॉल, आई हैव फॉर 10 डिफरेंट थिंग्स, 10 डिफरेंट एडवर्टाइजमेंट्स, ओके, एंड 10 डिफरेंट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग यूनिट्स ऑल्सो. बिकॉज एक जगह पर जहाँ पे शैम्पू बना रही हूँ, सेम टाइम में आई कैन नॉट मेक दी अनदर वन. सो वैसे I can generate employment for multiple people and in multiple states, locations and places. Automatically improve standard of living for any person, whether be it a city or be it a rural area. Survival of communication media. If as a company I do not give advertisements, what will the media do? Media or TV channels also get money out of the advertisements that they air on television or on radio. Otherwise, just to have a news channel or get high TRP ratings will not make money for a particular channel. So advertisements are the actual, you can say, breadwinners for a particular television channel. Creates healthy competition. Healthy competition, say between Domino's, Pizza Hut and all other places, they all have their own 30-minute ka funda, or there is more cheese in this, or there is more butter in that. So all that creates a good healthy competition between the products so that customers buy my product. Economic development. So whether it is a company that has come from outside, from a foreign location to our country in India, or it's our own Indian brand, for example, we have Patanjali. Depending on the amount of sales that is generated, the tax that I pay or the profits that I give automatically helps the growth of my country. So many a times what happens, if you have heard about FDI in retail, a certain amount of profits will go to the home country from where the company has come, but that company has to employ our people, it has to take all resources from our country itself, and also it has to give back to the country in some form or the another. So that is why it helps in economic development. So this, you have business, consumers and society, advantages for advertising. Disadvantages. Adds to cost. Advertisement is expensive. Radio mein ho, TV mein ho, newspapers mein ho, magazine mein ho, anywhere you want to give an ad, it is an expensive proposition. Then, undermines social values. Many a times, advertisements just to get that money from the customers do not focus on what is actually there. So, for example, you have mobile phones. Everybody knows mobile phones may radiation hai, it is not good for you. You are supposed to you not keep it in your pocket. You are supposed to keep it away from your ear. But nobody tells you that in an advertisement. Because even if they say one negative thing about that particular product, people are not going to buy it. So, socially or otherwise, health-wise, even if it affects you, they are selling their product. Confuses the buyers. Jitne zyada options hai, utna zyada hum confuse hote hain. So, before LPG, that is liberalization, privatization and globalization, India had Indian products, Indian companies. So, there was only two companies that used to manufacture cars. Ek ambassador tha aur ek premier Padmini tha. Hindustan Motors, that is it. So, there was no choice of, you know, an SUV or a TUV or some other kind or a Lamborghini or a Ferrari or an Audi or any of those things. It was the standard ambassador and the premier Padmini, which used to be the favorite of everybody. Yes, there used to be those old vintage cars also. Wo chakkar wale, aise pahiye wale sab. They also were manufactured by Hindustan Motors itself. So, one per company, few options, everybody is happy. More the companies, more the options, everybody is confused. Ye lu, wo lu, ye gaadi achha hai, wo gaadi achha hai, iska feature kya hai, uska feature kya hai, confuses the buyers. Then, encourages sale of inferior products. If you ever go to a small shop, paan patti ka dukaan, there is, you get something called as a dhana dal. Premchand ka dhana dal, itna chota. Now, Premchand dhana dal is a branded product. But, wo Premchand dhana dal ke naam pe, many companies sell inferior products. If you ever get the time to go and visit a shop in Dharavi, okay, next to the Indira Gandhi market, jaise hi leather factory ke wahan se andar jaoge, there are these chota chota units where they sell this dhana dal in the name of Premchand dhana dal, which is obviously bad. Similarly, you get a lot of leather goods of with branded labels, but they are actually of inferior quality. So, it encourages sale of inferior products too. Now, how do I know about all this? Word of mouth communication. Unethical advertisement. This is an unethical advertisement. Why? Because pan masala is not good for your health. Per se. According to the Advertising Council, alcohol, ye pan masala or cigarettes, bidi, cigars, ye sari cheezo ka advertisement aap nahi kar sakte on the media. Be it television, radio, print, anything. So, if I have an advertisement like this, it means it is an unethical advertisement. It is not according to the ethics of the Advertising Council. Now, we move to appeals. Appeals are form of advertisements which are made to focus on the customer and to bring out that feeling. So, when you see an advertisement, certain advertisements give you certain feel. So, jaise you can see this. Johnson's Baby ke jitne bhi ads aate hain, ekdam soft music. Mummy aise bache ko leke ja rahi hai, you know, lot of motherly love, affection, all that is shown. And that is what? To play with your emotions so that you have a certain feeling of that motherly love when you see the ad. So, I have an example here. So what did the ad show? a professor who's worked for more than 50 years is retiring from that institute, and his students have actually come up with a good thought of giving him a farewell gift. So, what does it try to do? It is actually trying to bring out the emotion of gifting, or it is trying to make you also emotional the way it is. So therefore, emotional appeal advertisements are targeted so that, you know, literally tum ro, acche wale aansu nikle when you see a particular advertisement. Personal appeal. Personal appeal is when you have ads on fear, on love, on friendship, anything apart something to not make you emotional. General ads which give you a very happy wala feeling, or a fear wala feeling, or when you are scared or afraid, those type of ads are personal ads because it has a certain of personal element to it.
Hi.
Hi. What's up?
I have something to say.
Is it a good thing or a bad thing?
Good thing. I hope.
Then say it.
Nitya,
huh?
Did you check the bread, right? Let's go check on that because it's been pretty long.
Oh, yeah. So, what were you saying?
Will you marry me?
What?
Will you marry me?
Was based on the guy proposing the girl. So the question he asked two times, will you marry me, will you marry me? Fatak se she says yes, but in a non-verbal format. He doesn't have a ring, what does he do? Apna ghadi leke pehna diya usko. This ad basically shows that there is a personal touch or an element to the ad. That is why they focus on personal appeals. It is not made to make you cry or make you feel emotional or make you feel any of those sorts. This is just a happy-go-lucky ad type of an ad. Social appeal. Social appeals are ad which basically focuses on social issues and also wants to create an awareness among all the consumers regarding health ho, या तो फिर गर्ल चाइल्ड हो गया, एजुकेशन हो गया और एनी सच सॉर्ट ऑफ इश्यूज. सो हियर डेटॉल का धुला वॉज बेसिकली फोकसिंग ऑन एवरी चाइल्ड एंड एवरी पेरेंट शुड एक्चुअली वॉश देयर हैंड्स बिफोर हैविंग फूड. सो इनकलकेट अ सेंस ऑफ वॉशिंग योर हैंड्स एवरी टाइम यू ईट फूड और यू गो टू द वॉशरूम और कम आउट और डू एनीथिंग. सो दैट वॉज फोकस्ड ऑन दिस. सिमिलरली, for more information on lung cancer, keep smoking. This is also a social issue ad which says that हाँ अगर आप फूकते रहोगे तो आपको lung cancer definitely होगा, फिर हम आपको बताएंगे तुमको क्या करना है. So to prevent that, they created an advertisement with a slight humor in it. Now this is called a sarcastic humor, not a real ones वाला. So this is also a social appeal ad. The appeal is please do not smoke or quit smoking. Humor appeal. So हमारे पास दो शेर हैं. One जिसके बाल एकदम frizzy है and after using the shampoo उसके बाल एकदम silky हो जाते हैं. So any type of ad print में if you have a certain type of humor to it, that comes under a humor appeal ad.
अरे मुंह फाड़ के काई देख रही हो? अठे मारो दोनों ही मटको फोड़ दियो। अरे काई तो बोलो, 5-5 रुपया का दो मटको फोड़ दियो मारो।
हिंदी गावलो, हम तुम्हें धरती से उड़ा देंगे।
से कुछ भी चिपक सकता है एंड इट हैड अ ह्यूमर अपील टू इट। अ रैशनल अपील कैन समटाइम्स बी सिमिलर टू अ फीचर अपील बिकॉज वो लॉजिक के बारे में ज्यादा सोचता है। जनरली एडवर्टाइजमेंट्स कैन ईदर बी कंप्लीटली इलॉजिकल एंड नॉनसेंस एंड दे कैन बी सम विद लॉजिक। There was this very old ad for, I guess, Center Fresh chewing gum or no, teeth whitening wala chewing gum tha, wherein everybody is some or the other object, inanimate object, and wo chewing gum khake daat ekdam safed ho jate hain and sabko light milti hai. Orbit, yeah. Now that is a completely illogical ad, which was only made to focus on the chewing gum per se. This is more of a rational ad, wherein there is no humor, there is no personal appeal or any of those things. They only focus on the product per se. So Horlicks Pure, taller, stronger, sharper bano, there is no scientific record for it. It is only because they say ki aisa hoga that people go and buy it. But sabko lagta hai, logically, haan correct ho sakta hai. Because usme iron hai, protein hai, calcium hai, etc. There are so many other things. So people generally have a feeling that this may actually help in making my child taller, stronger or sharper. Similarly, this is an ad for a floor cleaner. So if I use a Bounty floor cleaner, then at least the rag that I use will be for more, that I can use that rag for much more opportunities or much more time as compared to if I use some other cleaner. It's like you have your Vim gel वाले एड्स, एक चम्मच लो और सारे बर्तन धो के निकालो। सो दे ऑल आर रैशनल अपील वाले एड्स। टाइप्स ऑफ एडवर्टाइजिंग, पब्लिक सर्विस। जब गवर्नमेंट्स एडवर्टाइजमेंट निकालती है, जागो ग्राहक जागो, या फिर मिशन धनुष, वैक्सीनेशन कराओ बच्चों के, सो ये सारी चीजें पब्लिक सर्विस एडवर्टाइजमेंट्स में। Institutional advertising, when it is focused per se on the institution. You have corporate advertising, that comes under an institutional ad. Political ads, Congress, BJP or any political party, when they remove an advertisement, it comes under a political advertisement. Financial ads, you have bank, you have insurance, you have government coming in saying pay your income tax by 31st of July. All these are financial ads. Trade and consumer ads are your normal advertisements that is focused on selling the product to the customer. Trade advertisements are those wherein you can see it is business to business, or you have exhibitions or expos or those kind of promotional activities that happen for a business to sell its product to another business. And finally, you have internet. You have your social media, you have your web marketing, you have MMS, you have SMSs, you have all these other kind of facilities available on the internet, your YouTube, when you put advertisements on YouTube, everything comes under your internet advertisements. So, this is an institutional ad where it focuses on the institution rather than the product or the service they give. Now, this is a news channel. News channel ka kya hai? Service hai. But rather than focusing on that, it is focusing on the institution, that is Times Now. Now again, this is also an example for unethical advertising. You know why? Republic TV, Arnab Goswami ne jo nikala hai, is its new thing. Uske upar, they have actually created a sort of an Cold War wala advertisement. So here, they are actually taking a dig at Republic TV that Times Now is actually the number one channel and Republic takes all its news from Times Now. Unethically, but still, the advertisement is shown only on its news channel. Institutional ads generally, okay, majorly focus only on that particular organization or on that particular channel. Public service ads, as I told you, government organizations, NGOs, when they create an advertisement on social issues or any other formats, it comes under a public service act because you are serving the people of the country or creating an awareness through this ad amongst the citizens.
Jaldi kar, jaldi kar. कितनी बार समझाया तेरी माँ को स्कूल की जरूरत ना है ना वो मानती है ना तू मानती
है भाई साहब
क्या मास्टर
क्या कर रहे हैं आप
देख नहीं रहा क्या कर रहा हूँ चल काम कर अपना तू चल
हर बुरी जिद का इलाज है एक अच्छी जिद जिद करो दुनिया बदलो दैनिक भास्कर देश का सबसे बड़ा न्यूज़पेपर ग्रुप
नाउ दिस इज एन एग्जांपल ऑफ एन इंस्टीट्यूशनल एड प्लस अ पब्लिक सर्विस एड व्हाई एन इंस्टीट्यूशनल एड दैनिक भास्कर इज अ न्यूज़पेपर ग्रुप जिसने ये एड बनाया है किस पे फोकसिंग ऑन गर्ल चाइल्ड एजुकेशन दैट वो है ना मुलगी शिकली प्रगति झाली ऑन दैट पर्टिक्युलर कॉन्सेप्ट टू टीच एवरी गर्ल चाइल्ड इन एवरी रूरल विलेज और एवरी पार्ट ऑफ द कंट्री दे हैव फोकस्ड दिस एज अ पब्लिक सर्विस एड टू क्रिएट अवेयरनेस ऑल्सो अ फाइनेंशियल एडवर्टाइजमेंट
छुट्टे को जुड़ जाने दो खुले कभी यहां कभी वहां को मिल जाने दो छुट्टे 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 हुए छुट्टे को जुड़ जाने दो खुले कभी यहां कभी वहां को मिल जाने दो छन छन करती चिल्लर की पार्टी हो जाने दो बटोरो जमाओ कमाओ आज की ही चिल्लर कल नोट बन जाने दो आज की ही चिल्लर कल नोट बन जाने दो
माय जूनियर अकाउंट
कोटक महिंद्रा बैंक।
फाइनेंशियल एडवर्टाइजमेंट्स फोकसिंग ऑन व्हाट? हाउ टू स्टार्ट इन्वेस्टिंग एट अ वेरी यंग एज सो दैट आफ्टर अ सर्टन अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम और अ सर्टन एज यू ऑलरेडी हैव अ लॉट इन योर बैंक अकाउंट। सोशल मीडिया, यू हैव फेसबुक, एडवर्टाइजमेंट ऑन फेसबुक, you have Snapchat, you have Instagram, you have your Twitter handles, you have your WhatsApp groups, anywhere, wherever you can promote your product, you promote using the internet comes under internet advertising.
मुझे चिप्स खाना है मम्मा, मैं क्या ये चॉकलेट थोड़ा खा सकती हूँ? That constant thing of I want to eat this, मुझे ये खाना है, junk food खाना है, वो चालू रहता है।
सुनते आ रहे हैं, पढ़ रहे हैं कि ये सब चीजों से दांतों में कैविटी लग जाता है।
After you brush her teeth with Colgate, then I'm, you know, secure as a mother.
इनकी तरह करोड़ों माएं कोलगेट पर भरोसा करती हैं। इसकी कैल्सीलॉक सुरक्षा दांतों में कैल्शियम लॉक करने में मदद करे, जिससे दांत रहें कैविटी से सुरक्षित।
दो बार ब्रश किया, I'm टेंशन फ्री।
माँ का भरोसा और डेंटिस्ट का सुझाया कोलगेट।
टाइप्स ऑफ मीडिया यूज्ड इन एडवर्टाइजिंग, you all know this very well. Direct mail, when you get any sort of advertisements in your mailbox, that comes under direct mail. It can be coupons, it can be offers, it can be any catalog or anything that comes to your house is a direct mail. Then magazines and newspapers, you have seen advertisements in Vogue, Femina, Good Housekeeping, Interiors, India Today, any place where you can see an advertisement or you can put an advertisement in print comes under newspapers and magazines. Then radio advertisements, and nowadays you also have train advertisements. Whenever you travel by a train, you can listen to Badshah Masala and so many other companies keeping on repeating their products. This is a film advertisement. So whenever I focus on promoting my cinema or my movie, be it the train or the bus or the Kapil Sharma show or any other place, as a promotion comes under film advertisement. Now over here, Slumdog Millionaire, the date when it is going to start, the tagline of the movie, everything is over here. Billboards. This is called outdoor advertising. So if you see a billboard, if you see the shutter of a shop with Balaji wafers painted on it, all that comes under outdoor advertising. Then you have TV advertisements. This is called a window display. Window displays per se, anytime you go to a mall, there is a fall collection or a summer collection or a spring collection displayed on the windowsills of that particular shop comes as window display. And that is why many a times when we go to the mall, we say we are going to do window shopping. Then this is an expo or an exhibition where trade to trade, that is business to business, business to business advertisements or exhibitions take place. So this is also a form of media where I can advertise the products or services of my company to use. Now, before TV ads came into existence in this country, we had something known as the print media. Now I'm going to show you a few ads via print media. And by the way, these organizations still exist in the country. Kirloskar Diesel Engine. Did you see the ad? It was based on a farmer and his wife and how I can use that particular product. Taj Zakir Hussain ka, wa Taj ke pehle ah Taj tha. So yahan pe she is nicely sitting and drinking Taj Mahal tea. Then ponds, fair and lovely ponds, etc. This is the first ad. It was done by the she was an actress called Jayashree. And yahan pe they also mentioned that ki yahan pe kaun hai karke. Lux soap ka sabse pehla ad was done by an actress called Leela Chitnis. And after that, it became very famous, and they use only actresses to promote a Lux product. And the only two male actors who have promoted Lux is one is Shah Rukh Khan, and the second one is Amitabh Bachchan. Otherwise, nobody else. It's all the actresses that do the advertisement. Ponds cream, that one. Ever seen airlines selling tickets? Air India sold its first advertisement from Goa, to Bombay for 217 rupees. So anywhere in the world you want to come to Bombay, 217 mein plane ticket mein aap aa sakte ho. So 1960s mein 200 was a very big thing. Abhi hum logon ko 200 mila to there is no use. Bonvita was actually started as an advertisement or as a print ad for grown-ups, not for kids. Bade boodon ke liye jinko energy nahi hai, unko energy badhana hai, to Bonvita piyo, usse energy aayega. To wo bachcho ke liye nahi tha, it was predominantly for old people. And then it moved on to the younger generation. So it was made in tin format, dabba bhi tin tha, packaging bhi alag tha. The entire this was a different thing altogether. Eno. So you see how old that product is. This is a 1960s print ad. Fruit salt settles the stomach, cleanses the system, keeps you fit. Mercedes. 26,000 mein Mercedes milta tha. Abhi 26,000 mein. You won't even get the steering wheel of that product. Price revision. So, the recent prices of Mercedes has now been deducted from 27,000 to 26,000. So, you could easily afford. And look at the Mercedes, by the way. Kaisa dikhta hai? Aur abhi ka Mercedes kaisa dikhta hai? Print advertisement. By the way, did you see that? Tata Mercedes Benz. So, when Mercedes came into India, it came through a merger or through a link up with Tata Group. This is for a talcum powder. Hum log powder lagate na, don't go wild. Bina talcum powder. Amul cheese. You want to see how old Amul cheese is? Be cheesy, choose Amul cheese. In three yummy sizes. And this girl, jo abhi bhi Amul butter pe dikhti hai, uska purana version and uska purana get up hai ye. Now, Amul was actually the brainchild of Sylvester Dacunha. He was one of the most prominent advertisers in those days because everything used to be print ads. And that is why Amul still has print ads, if you see. Billboards pe kabhi bhi jao, on any social topic or any topic, they always have a print ad. Computer, KSRTC pioneers computerized ticket reservations. This is the first time you had a computer reservation. So it is not something that happened in 2000, it is something that happened in 1960s and 70s. So per se, you have a lot of old advertisements. So in the 60s and the 70s, before TV or Doordarshan came into the picture, people used to have advertisements which were print media only. And mostly black and white. Because ink was most costly as compared to a black and white advertisement. Now if you see this one, Luna Moped does not even exist anymore. Or for that matter, aajkal koi bana ke bechta bhi nahi hai. But us zamane mein, school teachers and teachers had a lot of respect, and anybody who used to have a Luna was really in the top race. So that is why you had advertisements based on these.
ये है मिस्टर राम मुरारी, अफसर हैं ये एक सरकारी। देर देर तक काम ये करते, फिर घर जाने से थे डरते। उनको सूझा एक उपाय, अगले दिन एक लूना लाए।
चल मेरी लूना,
लूना करती पक्का वादा। खर्चा कम, मजबूती ज्यादा, अब काम भी है पूरा कर पाते, घर में ज्यादा वक्त बिताते।
सुख पाना है तुमको दूना, शान से बोलो चल मेरी लूना।
सफलता की सवारी लूना।
From can't you see you're so high above the knee, but I'm growing mommy. You play basketball, don't come when I go, but I'm growing mommy. You put doggy up so high, can you please tell me why? But I'm growing mommy.
Complan has all the 23 vital foods, including milk protein, that growing children need.
I'm a Complan girl. I'm a Complan boy.
Complan, complete bland food in a variety of yummy flavors.
I love a Complan mommy.
जब मैं छोटा लड़का था, बड़ी शरारत करता था, मेरी चोरी पकड़ी जाती। जब रोशन होता बजाज, अब मैं बिल्कुल बूढ़ा हूँ, गोली खा कर जीता हूँ, लेकिन आज भी घर के अंदर रोशनी भी ना बजाज।
रोशनी की दुनिया का सरताज।
Coming into the picture, they were not more than 15 to 20 seconds per se. Later on, thoda thoda karke, the time increased because people wanted to show ki features zyada hai, ya to fir usme appeal aane laga, emotion aane laga, ye sari cheeze uske andar they started to put. So again it evolved to a different time.
अरे बबलू, यहाँ क्या कर रहे हो?
सब गुस्सा करते हैं, मैं घर छोड़ के जा रहा हूँ।
मगर घर में तो मम्मी ने गर्मा गर्म जलेबियाँ बनाई है।
जलेबी?
तय किया आपने?
जाना तो है मगर।
हाँ, मगर 20-25 साल बाद।
अनोखी शुद्धता, अनोखा असर। धारा।
बच्चे के पढ़ने रेंडे मूने नाले अंजे
चुटकी में चिपकाए वेरी क्विक
कुछ खास है हम सभी में कुछ बात है हम सभी में बात है खास है कुछ स्वाद है क्या स्वाद है
कैडबरी स्टेरी मिल्क असली स्वाद जिंदगी का
जब घर की रौनक बढ़ानी हो दीवारों को जब सजाना हो मैरोले रंगों की दुनिया में आओ रंगीन सपने सजाओ मैरोले
हर रूप हर रंग में बेहतर
song and even Nerolac paints still use the same song that they used somewhere in the 1990s. Nirma is also actually a case study because he was the only person, Karsan Bhai Patel, who actually sold the entire Nirma brand and actually made the entire Nirma brand come up single-handedly beating Hindustan Unilever ka Wheel and Surf and all those products. So that is why his is a very commendable thing. Now this is 2000s. So what I am trying to show is the evolution of advertisement from 1960s to abhi 2017.
बेटे, कल तुम्हें लड़के वाले देखने आ रहे हैं।
पर माँ,
हाँ?
मेरी त्वचा।
दीदी। इंस्टेंट फेयरनेस चाहिए तो ये लो
ये
साधारण क्रीम असर दिखाए 5 दिनों में पर बजाज CFL से पाइए बस 1 सेकंड में उजला गोरा रंग बजाज CFL सब कुछ रोशन कर दे
She's hot! Indeed! मुझे छोटी वाली पसंद है।
सबका वॉल्यूम ऊंचा कर दे बिल्ट इन एम्पलीफायर वाला गोदरेज DVD प्लेयर
आई लव यू
But what this organization really needs is a one-on-one approach.
Easily erasable. Camlin whiteboard markers.
Actually, what this organization really, really needs is repositioning. That means that
I'll go.
Excuse me.
I'm just crossing over.
Easily erasable. Camlin whiteboard markers.
What this organization desperately needs is change.
Easily erasable. Camlin whiteboard markers.
फिर से हाथ घिस गए पर दाग नहीं गए.
इंस्टेंट सफेदी चाहिए तो ये लो.
साधारण डिटर्जेंट ना दे पाए मन चाहिए सफेदी, मगर बजाज CFL दे चुटकी में चमकती सफेदी.
बजाज CFL सब कुछ रोशन कर दे.
मगा मजा.
So, ads started to have a humor appeal in them when it came to the year 2000. Naya era, naya century, naya saal. So, everybody wanted to focus on ads which will make people happy and remember the ads rather than having the ads jo ro ro ke ya fir aisa kuch ho. So, 60s mein it were all prints, 60s and 70s. 80s mein they started using jingles. तो वो अजंता का जो एड है या जो लूना का एड था, चल मेरी लूना एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा, ये सब लोगों की जबान पे याद रहता था बिकॉज उसमें एक म्यूजिक एक कैची ट्यून था. सिमिलरली जब 1990s में आया तो वो धारा का जो एड था जिसमें जलेबी खा रहा है वो, या तो फिर आगे के जो भी एड्स थे, वो निर्मा का एड गाने की तरह लंबा लंबा गाना सब याद रखते थे बिकॉज इट वॉज वेरी कैची एंड वेरी डांसिंग डांसी काइंड ऑफ ए ट्यून. Focusing on that, removing that, they started coming on humor appeal. That is, usme gana wana nahi hai. There is no jingle, there is no Jaya Rekha Sushma or anybody. It was solely focused on the actual product and the feature per se. So, jo Godrej DVD player ka advertisement tha, uska feature appeal kya tha? Ki uska sound bahut zyada hai. To jo bhi wo डीवीडी प्लेयर यूज करता है उनका साउंड ऑटोमेटिकली लाउड हो जाता है. सो वैसे ह्यूमर अपील के बेसिस पे दे स्टार्टेड मेकिंग एडवर्टाइजमेंट्स एज एन एवोल्यूशन. नाउ आफ्टर दिस यू ऑल ऑलरेडी नो अभी के एडवर्टाइजमेंट्स कैसे हैं. यू ऑल हैव सीन एडवर्टाइजमेंट्स फॉर कोक और पेप्सी और एनी गाड़ी का हो या तो फिर थम्स अप का हो. नाउ देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ एलिमेंट यूजिंग द फिल्म स्टार्स. There is a lot of action, adventure and all those kind of advertisements are the current genre of this particular era. Now, apart from these ads, unethical advertising. I showed you an example of unethical advertising over there, jahan pe there was wo Pierce Brosnan ka, Rajnigandha ka. This is one more unethical ad.
Hmm.
Now this was actually a fight between Sprite and Mountain Dew. So Mountain Dew ka tagline was do the dew. So Sprite and Mountain Dew same products hain. Dono clear liquid hain, dono carbonated hain. Ek Pepsi ka brand hai aur ek Coke ka brand hai. So actually Mountain Dew first came up with an ad jahan pe un log Sprite ka mazak uda rahe the that wo sab bakwas hai, Sprite matlab pura bakwas hai, etc, etc. That is why Sprite also came up with a counter ad regarding do the dew, no do either, do jhadi ka piche, all gyan, no bakwas. So these are unethical advertisements. Aap ek dusre ke company ko, even if you are competitors, aise ads bana ke public ke samne image kharab nahi kar sakte. And ye ad exactly wahi kar raha hai, Mountain Dew ka image kharab karne ki koshish. Print advertisements. Tide. Kabhi sachi mein dekha hai? Tide itna saaf hota hai. Misleading the customer. Dove ka ad. Dove use karo and you automatically from brown you turn fair. If that was the condition, to pure world mein sab gore hote. Even Africa ke sare. Fair and Lovely in our own country. Have you ever used Fair and Lovely and actually seen people coming out like a tube light? Nice and fair? No, they don't. That is why Fair and Lovely is also a form of unethical advertisement. Surrogate ads. Surrogate ads are ads which are created for products which have been banned by the Advertising Council to be displayed publicly. So your cigarettes, your alcohol, all these kind of ads have something called as the surrogate advertisement.
What you wanna be, taking things away they come. Nothing is as cool as drifting in the sunlight, dancing to Bacardi.
Bacardi house party abhi recently hua hai. So you had kya iska naam hai, Armin Van Buren and so many other people come down for this Bacardi house party. Now we all know Bacardi sells music CDs, okay, as a surrogate advertisement. But actually Bacardi kya hai? Alcohol hai. They have vodka, rum, wine, whatever, whatever in the Bacardi catalog. But since we cannot sell alcohol or all these cigarettes and such things openly in public, we make surrogate advertisements. Carlsberg club glasses aate hain, but actually Carlsberg beer hai. Kingfisher ka pani aata hai, sparkling mineral water, but actually it is again a form of beer. So similarly Bacardi also is actually an alcohol brand, but they sell music CDs as a surrogate advertisement. So with this we come to the end of our chapter on advertising. If you all have any questions, you all can ask me now, or if you have questions later on, you can always contact me on my email ID. So any questions? Thank you so much.